Welcome to Smells Like 90's Rock. It is Shiela, Hot Toddy, and Baby J here tonight. Welcome, Baby J. Thanks for being
on
the show.
I'm excited when Baby J comes.
It's always a nice time. She hasn't been on the show in a long time.
I know. I thought she hated me.
No, she loves everybody.
I just also love sleep.
She loves sleep, so that's why she hasn't been on the live shows. And then when we pre-record, we've been pre-recording on nights
that
she works late, so she's not been in the house when we've been recording. So, but we are live tonight, and spoilers ahead here. Mr. DJ P.O.R.C. himself. DJ P.O.R.C. becomes, after almost 2 years, the second person to fall on Smells Like 90's Rock to COVID-19. That's right.
Bum, 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 bum.
P.O.R.C. has COVID-19. So a round of applause.
Whee! For P.O.R.C. What do I get for being the last sold out?
You know what? It's an exclusive club now, so I'm afraid you get this. It's you're not cool enough to join the COVID club.
Well, that's not fair.
Go out and get COVID then.
No, I mean, don't. I should have like some sort of special prize.
Well, you do. You have all your health. Now I'm calling DJ P.O.R.C. right now.
I was about to say, what is that?
I'm calling P.O.R.C. on the thing. Let's see if we can't get him on the thing here. This requires you to answer, P.O.R.C.
Did you like message him?
I told him I would be calling here in just a second.
Okay. Did he respond?
Maybe he fell asleep.
It is late.
He said at the beginning, this was like right as the show was starting. Hey, we're calling you. Wait, there he is.
Wow, it took him like 10,000 hours.
You're here, P.O.R.C. Yes, we hear you.
Can you hear me?
I hear you. Can you hear us?
I can hear you.
All right.
I can see you too, so.
Yay.
Hey, it came through. So, how are things?
I mean, I guess the circumstances could be worse.
Well,
I'm just
how are you feeling?
Yeah, how are you feeling?
I just have a bad sore throat is all.
It drove me crazy watching her testify because, like, you would always see her, like, look over and, like, cheese at the jury. Like, you believe me, don't you?
Yeah.
And I'm like, no, stop. Look forward. That's going to help you a lot more.
I still love the meme. I stepped on a bee.
I stepped on a bee.
My dog hit his knee.
That, and like she did her hair way too well for the trial.
Right?
Like she
looked like you're hurt.
Yeah, like she if she was trying to get sympathy, she had to show up there looking a little rough sometimes.
That was the worst part. Yeah, that was the worst part. Her coming in looking glorious, marvelous every day.
Yeah, because, like, that means she woke up with enough time to do that. Baby J, you know what I'm talking about. Like,
yeah,
we,
girl.
We wake up and, like, kind of roll out sometimes.
Mm-hmm.
And if we're going on a 3-week trial, there's going to be at least a few days where we just rolled out.
Honey, it's messy bun. That's the way you're putting it up.
Not me. Even during this time of no job, I still wake up and make myself look fabulous.
He does.
Look at my hair. Looks fabulous.
First of all, you don't have nearly the amount of pressure that makes you look fabulous as what we have.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Girl, you want to try again?
I do. What is your skincare regimen like?
What's the soap we use?
Irish Spring.
Irish Spring. That's what gets me through the day.
We've already lost. You've already lost. Sorry. Have like at least two or three more potions and lotions and creams and lotions than like the Irish Spring bar.
Yeah. What'd you say, P.O.R.C.?
I said my skincare routine is a lot more intense than usual this week because I think I'll develop a shellfish allergy, which is super inconvenient considering where I work.
You got a shellfish allergy.
You probably have a COVID rash.
Oh yeah, that's true.
Either you had a slight immunity or a slight allergy to it, and the fact that your immunity is so low, it made it more prominent.
Maybe it just I've noticed the last few times I've eaten shrimp that I feel like a faint tingling or numbness in my mouth.
Mm-hmm.
So I feel like that's...
Stop that.
Yeah, that's not great.
So let me get this straight.
Maybe don't eat those.
You're now allergic to your own job?
Mm. Yeah, I know. Isn't it great?
You need to get you an EpiPen, though, son, for real.
Yeah.
If you're working at the fancy Long John Silver's, because sometimes it won't be terrible, and then that one time it is, you die.
Yeah,
so
she right.
Make sure I do it around people. Well, and I really I ate a salad with a lot of shellfish on it like Monday, and then all of a sudden I broke out. So, and then I developed my COVID symptoms on late Tuesday, maybe early Wednesday.
It still could be because of
COVID. I assume it's...
It could be.
But I don't know. It's just, there's like overlap between the symptoms. I'm not sure exactly what's causing it, but I'm gonna stay away from shellfish for a minute.
I mean, that's smart.
Yeah. I think I can at least handle it. I can't eat it.
I was about to say, how can he stay away from it? He works with it every day.
Gloves.
Well, I can at least handle it. I can't eat it.
Yeah.
I don't know, man, because, like, it'll get worse. Because, like, there's been some times when you've come in right from the Long Johns, and, like, my throat starts getting scratchy because you have the shrimp smell on you. Like,
the smell causes a reaction.
The worst one I ever had was the time I had to serve popcorn shrimp at the Barrel. I became like a puffy, Stay Puff person, but red.
Can we ask the question, why do they serve shrimp at Cracker Barrel? That is the dumbest thing.
They serve whatever people will buy.
Mm-hmm.
Like, because that's home cooking.
Who gets shrimp at Cracker Barrel?
The people who can't afford to go to Red Lobster.
Who?
Then go to Long John's.
Who gets seafood from Red Lobster? Because that's not real seafood.
It's more seafood than Cracker Barrel. Than the Barrel,
yeah. Like, I mean...
Not to me.
The seafood was not nearly as depressing to me as people who would order steak.
At the Barrel?
At the Barrel.
I mean...
No.
I'm guilty of that.
Yeah, what's wrong with the steak?
That is some hamburger with a marked up price.
You know what?
Okay.
I ate a fish fillet sandwich and barbecue sauce the other day.
He did.
I'm telling you. He goes,
go to McDonald's. Don't get tartar on it. And I'm like, okay, come home. He goes, runs to the kitchen, comes back. All of a sudden I hear... And it's... Barbecue sauce
sniffs
all over the fish.
It was great. Have you ever done that? Pork, have you ever done that? You work in fish.
I don't work in barbecue, though.
Have you ever put barbecue on a fishy meal?
No.
No. It's weird.
It is weird.
That's like a stoner meal right there.
Well... I'm one step below, so it's fine. I'm unemployed, so I'm one step below.
Did they teach that in the cult? I feel like that's something the cult taught you. Pray to the Omega Mega Tuna, and like we put barbecue sauce on it to bring it to the land.
You know, if that was one of the lessons, I wasn't around long enough for it.
He didn't pay attention.
Yeah, no, I didn't pay attention.